thinking, something you probably don't think about very often until something flies in your eye and you involuntarily blink like crazy trying to get it out. It seems we spend over 10% of our waking life blinking, which is a lot, but what if we stopped? Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions. I'm your host Rebecca Felgate, a serial blinker, and today I'm asking, what if we stopped blinking? Before we get into this video, I want to start our eye chat by asking you what colour your eyes are. Mine are pretty difficult to describe, but I'm going to go with muddy green when there's no light shining in them and kind of a yellowy green when there is. Let's get some eye colour chat going on in the comment section down below. Also, do please leave a thumbs up on this video and stick around to the end to hear some comment responses. One thing's for sure, if we all stopped blinking indefinitely, we would share the same eye colour. Red. Okay, so before we talk about the skill that is blinking, I want to talk about our sponsor, Skillshare. I've talked about Skillshare before, and honestly, I can't get enough of their service. Skillshare is an online learning community with thousands of classes in loads of amazing areas, such as photography, cooking. They even have classes on how to go viral online. If you're into design, tech, gaming, or you want to grow your business, there is a class for that on Skillshare. I want to specifically draw your attention to this class by influencer Matt Balassi. He has created a 70-minute class on making content that people want to share. One of his lessons includes pizza baiting. Great. Skillshare is really affordable with an annual subscription of less than $10 a month, making it more affordable than any other skill sharing platform. Premium membership can give you unlimited access to classes from experts in different fields. So on the one hand, you can be learning about YouTube best practice or going viral, but you can also be learning how to design your own game or just design your own garden. Right now, we have a 2-month free trial for the first 500 people signing up using our special link. It is down there in the description box, just waiting for people looking to enhance their skills. Okay, blinking. So it seems that we humans blink between 10 to 20 times a minute. A blink lasts just a fraction of a second, but like I said in the intro, we still spend over 10% of our waking lives doing it. The reason we blink is twofold. One, it keeps our eyes healthy, and two, it keeps our mind healthy. Let's start with the eyes. Blinking is an involuntary reflex from the cerebrum part of the brain. This is also the part of the brain which controls our heartbeat, so it's super subliminal. Each time we blink, we spread oil and mucus across the surface of our eyes that keeps them nice and lubricated. It helps protect our eyes from really bright lights and also helps sweep the eye clean of foreign bodies like dust and smoke or, God forbid, a little fly. Can I just actually interrupt the flow of my own video for a second and let you know that I think there are few things in the world worse than scooping a dead fly out of your eyeball. Oh my God, and on those occasions when it goes behind your eyeball and you think that there'll be a dead fly in your body forever. But luckily, you keep blinking and eventually it comes out. Blech. So, if we stopped blinking, it would mess with our eyeballs in a very unpleasant way. Firstly, we would produce reflex tears, which helps when our eyes get super dry. Have you ever stepped outside on a cold winter's day and wonder why your eyes are running? Cold and dry air, my friends. But after the initial runny eye fest, our eyes would start to get very red and very itchy. It would become pretty unbearable after around half an hour. I want to interject with an anecdote here. In 2011, one Fergal Fleming made headlines when he beat Stephen Stagg in a staring contest in Darwin, Australia. Fergal Eyesore Fleming kept his eyes open for an eye-watering 40 minutes and 59 seconds. Now, he said that it felt like he was getting an eyeball tattoo around the 35-minute mark. Precious. Long term, it would be agony. It'd be like a kind of backwards bird box from your nightmares. Your eyes wouldn't be able to blink to clear debris, which would build up in your eyes over hours. And ugh, what would even happen if a fly got in there? Oh my God, no! Yuck. If you can't blink, how would you ever actually get it out? Well, if we stopped blinking, the biggest industry in the world would be eye drops, right? We could help ourselves and stave off infections by cleaning our eyes with drops, but we would need to keep on bending over to get the drops out. If we can't blink, we're just gonna have to hope gravity gets that water away from us. The constant need for eye drops would play havoc with, you know, doing anything, ever. Without blinking and with a constant need to use eye drops to see, we couldn't do things like drive a car or ride a bike or walk at length. It would be hazardous. If this was a universal rule of no blinking, this would also rule out travel. How can you trust a pilot, a train driver, or a ship captain if they can't even see properly? A lot of us would end up getting nasty eye infections, and likely over time, if we didn't blink from now until the day we die, we would actually likely lose our vision, be it from light exposure or infection, which would definitely suck, although maybe it would be a relief after all of the issues we inherit from not being able to blink but still desperately trying to see. Some of us may even lose our eyes altogether. Have you ever sneezed with your eyes open? No, you haven't. As a reflex, your eyes close when you sneeze in order to literally hold them in. Whether they would actually pop out with a big sneeze, well, it's unlikely, but that's what your body is trying to prevent. So, the second reason that we blink. Now, it seems that blinking is scientifically linked to our ability to focus and concentrate. In 2012, an experiment was conducted by the University of Osaka in Japan, in which people were observed watching clips from classic British TV comedy Mr. Bean. It seems that viewers synchronized their blinks at times that required less attention. The researchers drew a link between cognitive function, and interestingly, research has also found that autistic people don't control their blinks in the same way, which draws a link between blinking and social disability. There needs to be more research, but it could be that blinking is an integral part of our brain function. Building on that too, without blinking we'd struggle to sleep, which we know harms our ability to perform tasks the next day and beyond. The good news is we're unlikely to stop blinking anytime soon. The world record for not blinking is unofficially held by Michael Thomas, who allegedly kept his eyes open for 1 hour and 5 seconds. Blinking seems as natural as breathing to us, so we'll just keep on doing it. Although, an ability not to blink may come in handy if we ever ran into Doctor Who's Weeping Angels or SCP-173, but I'll let Jack Finch tell you all about that in his very own episode of Life's Biggest Questions. So guys, what did you think to this video? Do you have a newfound love of blinking? Let me know. Also, a big thanks to our video sponsor Skillshare. Please do use our link to get a 2-month free trial and join 7 million others who are learning with Skillshare. Before I get out of here, I'm just going to read some comments from What If the Golden Gate Bridge Collapsed. Now, Stupid Upload said, what if water levels went down by 1 mile? Good question. Jerry Boy said, my closest landmark is Stonehenge. Woo! Shout out England, shout out Wiltshire. Alexander said, my closest landmark is the Morro da Cursa in the city of Natal, Brazil. Did I pronounce that correctly? Either ways, shout out Brazil. Alright guys, that is all I have time for. Please do leave a thumbs up on this video and share it with a friend. I'm your host Rebecca Felgate, I'll catch you in the next video. But until then, stay curious, stay alert, and never ever stop questioning.